time, you have a meeting. Everything's on telly.
Yeah, the match is on.
Well, it's up to you.
So that's my first objection of the night.
I start. Good evening, everybody.
Good evening.
Anyone got any interest?
No.
Okay. Not last week. Any massive horizon?
No.
Just showing them.
I'll second it.
Second it?
Me.
Who seconded it?
Yeah. Andrew's.
Looking at the agenda, item 4 will be exempt item, I believe. Then we're going to move that, second it. Item 4 will be exempt item.
Agreed.
Okay. Right, back to, we'll leave that to the end of the agenda, item 4 then. Item 3, review of Hackney. And who have you got to speak? Derek? Just that. Oh, sorry, Barbara's going to say a few words to me.
Thank you, Chair. The purpose of this report is for members to consider representations received in respect of a proposed increase to the Hackney Carriage fare tariff advertised in accordance with the decision of this committee on the 25th of November. Members are asked to consider the representations made and determine whether or not to amend the table of fares as a result of the representations that have been made. And as indicated, Chair, there are people who do want to speak to you this evening regarding that.
Okay. Derek, do you want to speak?
Unless you...
No, please, Derek, you first.
Then I just want to speak.
It's not likely, obviously, but it's not the
yeah. Okay. I mean, just it's probably the wrong place to do it at the JCC. I actually think that Mrs. Calvert should, and I thank Mrs. Calvert for doing all the work, is that you send a newsletter around and make them aware that this is the, if we PCO, this will be the new increase. Do you agree with it, yes or no? And they can take that and they can send it back on with their own expense, of course. And it could be either me, you, or anybody else can come and scrutinize it, can't it?
That's
yep.
Not
so if you just added that and you sent it back and say we agree with this, we don't agree, then they're seeing that, that everybody gets a say, and obviously you just go with the majority. Just
okay. Any other questions again?
No. No.
Just to clarify, Derek is referring to that as a proposal. We did in fact do that, and that's what's generated the response that you were considering at the meeting in the and now.
But that would be an extra thing that if you actually almost had that as a ballot, do you agree with this, yes or no? And then it would stop all the, this is the second meeting we've had for the same thing, and it would stop all that.
And I represent the opposed, right. The people who signed the petition saying no to the actual increase.
Can you switch your mic on?
Switch it on? Right, basically, as I said, I'm here for the opposed, for the people who have actually signed the petition saying that they feel that it increases a little bit too much at the moment. As we said at the last meeting in November, when the committee quite rightly decided that they would put the proposal that the union put forward into the local papers and get a response from that. But from what I can understand is, you've had quite a lot to license and have had quite a lot of emails saying off people, off members of the public, saying that they don't want to rise. I mean, please correct me if that's wrong, Mrs. Calvert. Okay, well, it doesn't matter if it's one or five. If it's one objection, it still has to be treated as an objection. Or correct me if I'm wrong, sorry. I mean, I may be wrong because, I'm just a taxi driver.
Oh, you're right.
I am right. Thank you very much. So, where we stood on our proposals in November was, we don't agree. We had rather a heated discussion. Different proposals were thrown out onto the floor, weren't done in the correct manner, weren't done in the correct protocol to be brought up at the meeting. And to be honest with you, it seemed like it was a bit of an old school. People getting up to the, sitting down, putting proposals forward, yes John, yes Margaret. Yeah, but and realistically, all questions should come through the chairman, and go from there. It shouldn't be like an open meeting, even though people are speaking and people have known each other for years and years.
Which meeting?
Well, what are you looking at?
What meeting?
In November. When we come in November, with the three proposals, there was a proposal for an increase to £3.50 on the meter, a proposal of the union for £3 on the audit, and then there was ourselves who didn't want the increase. All I can say to you is, there is people out there that don't want it, and make a decision. It's whatever it is, we will stand by it. But at this present time, we think that it's not the right time to have an increase, and maybe look at it maybe next year. But unfortunately, as I say, it's been publicised in the paper. You've had responses of people that don't you know, members of the public that don't think it should be increased, as well as members of the taxi, you know, the taxi providers. And that's all I've got to say.
Well, I'd just like to say, as the chair, we have to, we're always fair, and this committee always likes to ask questions, and every committee will be down to, and that's what the point is.
Thanks.
Okay.
Maybe that was the incorrect way to put it.
What position is it, 49?
Sorry?
How many was on the position, 49?
I think it was 47 on the opposition.
Oh, I'm finished, yes. Sorry. Also, I take a start with what you say about the non-review flight people. But I think if you ask a question of anybody, of any subject, do you want an increase, the answer would be no.
Well, yeah, I appreciate that. But, you know, when the answer is being no, it's obviously that people can't afford an increase. You know, basically how I see it, if the increase comes, how little or how big, whatever it is, people are going to think twice about ringing for a cab or going to a rank for a cab when they can go and get a private hire. You know, basically, I feel that, you know, myself personally, the people that signed the petition, you know, once again, do not want an increase.
Well, just to set your mind at rest as well, I've been the chair of this committee in the past, and I was really prefer we ask all John that we don't, it's not an old voice, we listen to everything. Our concerns are their Labour.
I know what you are.
We look at everything fairly, don't we? It's not politicised or anything. So you can rest assured that's not.
Okay, but well, please accept my apologies through the chair to the committee.
Okay, very accepted.
Can I just interrupt? Very briefly, I apologise. The cat actually survived the operation, and that's why I'm here now.
Okay. Councillor Sullivan.
Just to expand on what John said again about the old board member, the work proposal brought in November, which weren't part of our brief, and we decided and we voted on it, where we should in this committee. We wouldn't even discuss them. So the proposals that were brought from the back of the room, we didn't even look at or discuss, and they weren't part of our agenda.
Well, in all fairness, Councillor, the proposals were actually brought from the chair here. They were actually brought from here.
Yes, they were, but we didn't.
No, you didn't let them come in, but really at the end of the day should they have been listened to without going through the right protocol. Thank you.
Well, if it goes to the right protocol, then that's what the officer is for.
Well,
that's
no, what I'm saying to you is
hang on, let me finish.
Okay.
Let me finish. And they go to the room, it's gotta be got one solicitor, the lawyer here.
Mm-hmm.
You've got the licensed people, you've got professional people who deal with this from day to day. Mm-hmm. Some of these people here have been on the license.
It's for all of us. You've got a petition and five members of the public.
Yeah, that's Charles Lydiard. I'm against pay rise because it would be detrimental to the trade as such. We've got private hire, cheap loans, Uber's now being licensed on the Wirral. We're just kicking ourselves into a grave if we put the prices up. I'm a union member, wasn't balloted. The proposal he'd done went before we get to vote on it every November. That's a good idea, that's a way forward. That way you get a representative vote of everyone, but at the moment, they say, I represent so many people, I'm actually in this branch, I never got asked. He doesn't represent me.
Well, I thought Derek before, when we talked about it, I thought Derek explained the process to. And then when I'm just saying, I'm looking around the table, I thought he did explain how he done.
Yeah, but he's sort of going forward. But he don't ask the members.
So, have we got any more to say?
No, that's pretty much it. I think it'll be detrimental to the trade, basically.
And where do you make out of just a matter of interest? Which part of the world?
Basically everywhere, but Hampton Square, Milton's, Weekend Hallway, New Brighton, further off, Heswell, West Kirby, Hog Lake.
Okay.
So.
Is there any questions, gentlemen? No? Okay, sir, thank you.
Okay, thank you.
Thank you. Is there any Margaret? Is there any comments? The manager, any more comments?
Chair, I've only got for and against, and we don't know how many for and how many against. So my recommendation would be to put it through to the cabinet.
It helps the situation, John. Yeah. If you want to propose to keep the status quo, we'll second you, alright?
Right. Thank you, Chair. As Andrew has proposed it, I'll say again, I'd like to leave it as status quo.
Move
to
second.
Is
that agreed?
So that an existing driver who wishes to renew their license so in a timely manner, and that any documentation that they submit is up to date, and they are not in a position whereby they've submitted, or we've submitted, an application on their behalf to the DBS, and the certificate comes back earlier than 28 days. Some certificates come back very quickly, others take a long time. So the proposal really is to deal with the part of the process that we can actually take control of, which is the submission of the DBS certificate. Thank you, Chair.
Okay.
Taxi drivers being penalised by time frames, that's going to assist them, so I'd be supporting it.
Don't come and join, say something. Yeah. Tell you what, you come first, and members may have some questions.
Okay, thank you.
Yeah.
Thank you. Yes, I applaud this. I think it's a common sense one. It's up and happened an awful lot of feedback about people who have difficulties. However, I'd like to make a request. Could you also add that time frame to the medicals as well? Because we've had lots of problems with medicals. Everyone's got their own different procedures. There was somebody who had only one doctor does them, and he went off, so he was panicking. And there's not much, and remember, it is in the 2 month time frame. It doesn't mean that it's been 2 months before it. So just give everybody time to get the DBS and the medical in.
Yes, Chair, if I can assist. The process for the medical is that the driver will get that medical in plenty of time. It is a matter for them really to organise that. They're in control of that process. They can come and get the medical up to 2 months before the renewal date. If they know, or if they, what we do is we send out a renewal reminder 2 months before. It used to be 1 month, but in order to give drivers that opportunity to get things done, we actually have it 2 months before, and they are given an appointment to come in, and at that appointment they are given a medical report to then take to make arrangements with their doctor. Margaret does administer some process whereby if there is real difficulty, we will facilitate that. I don't know if Margaret's got anything more to add to that.
Well, all I can say is that the applicant is given 2 months' notice to get the medical organised. So, in effect, it does have 2 months' notice. The appointment has to be within 28 days of the expiry date, but they've got a month in which to organise it, which in a lot of cases is ample time.
Well, can I say that when you say they're in control of the situation, they're not, because they're at the mercy of the surgery. That's all I'm saying is that I think the 2 months for DBS is very sensible, but we're having trouble also with surgeries not being able to book appointments. I know 2 months sounds quite a lot, but it's by the time you get into cancellations or sickness, it isn't, or 28 days, it should say.
Okay, I've got three councillors, Steve Niblock, Andrew Hodson, and Councillor. Yeah, thank you, Chair. I understand where Mr. Cummings is coming from. I would second the movement of the recommendation by Councillor Hodson. Anyway, perhaps Mr. Cummings could bring this to the JCC, and it could be debated in more detail.
I agree with Councillor Hodson, but I have to say I don't agree with what Mr. Cummings has just said. My husband has to have a medical every 2 years. There are two people in the North West that can carry them out. If he doesn't get a reminder, and he has to remember to do it himself, and if he doesn't get it, he can't work. And it's just a question of organising it around his holidays, the doctor's holidays. You know, that's part and parcel of his job, so I actually don't I don't agree with that. I think they're very lucky to get 2 months' notice, a reminder at all.
Well, I still stand by what I said at the beginning. I've heard what you've had to say, Derek. Having said that, this is what Margaret said, and this isn't the type of thing. We also agree with what Steve just said. We can't make things on the hoof sack on this table. We've got this here because a lot of time and effort gone into it. you want to make some progress with regards to the doctors, then Steve's right, which is what I was going to say, is the JCC is the place to bring it up by here. You raise a word of it, but it's not something we can decide tonight and just tack it on.
Okay, so to be helpful, Danny, take it to the JCC. Okay. Probably going to give the recommendations.
Agreed.
Yeah, good. Number six, the Green Award.
It's an annual report that we brought to the committee in respect of a green nomination that we've put forward by the Rural Award Working Party, to which some members actually sit on. There are nominees that have been recommended, members are aware of those nominees, and the report indicates or requests that the committee agree to confer the Rural Award upon those recipients recommended. The recipients don't necessarily know that they have been necessarily put forward, so arrangements will be then being made following members. The committee this evening, if members are minded to agree the recommendation, and arrangements then will be made for the for a ceremony to take place with the nominees invited at a future time. The report otherwise on that is self-explanatory.
Okay. Item 4 was made an exempt item because we're talking to the sun for that. It's financial applications, that's why it's been made exempt. So thanks for the public for attending tonight, because that's the last item on this agenda.
So did you pass the exemption for
Sorry,
I thought you were talking about four. I thought they were talking about four. Just by confusion. Okay, thanks.